I'm Dr. Ken Erickson. I'm the Chief Product Officer for Krimzen. Yesterday I spoke a little bit about inventory management. The actual topic, I believe it was called out of stock equals out of business. How to manage your inventory like a marijuana mogul, I think was the total title. Try to make it kind of fun. A lot of times inventory is not a very fun topic. And a lot of people don't necessarily see it as something very powerful, but it's actually one aspect of marijuana business that we see is a very powerful tool that's not really being utilized. It's being underutilized. When you can use it in the proper way, it actually becomes this tool to help grow your business. But the way it's managed for a lot of business owners is it's actually becomes this ball and chain that actually holds you down. It actually limits your growth because you have a ton of money tied up in your inventory, which means you don't have any money to be able to use for other things like business expansion, maybe going into a second facility, or being able to offer multiple different products that your customers are looking for. So we very much have taken a customer first approach to make sure that you can actually supply everything that your customers want, keep them happy, keep them coming back, and a lot of that has to do with your inventory, making sure the quality of it's good, and making sure that you have the cash flow and the revenue needed to be able to expand your business or to go out and reach new customers you can then bring into your business. And to me, you're going to start to see a lot of the challenges that have existed in pretty much every other industry other than cannabis. And a big one of those is competition. And competition in the past, it really hasn't been that much of a problem because the supply and demand really worked in the favor of the business owner. Now we're finding that the customer is king. And that's always been the case in pretty much every other industry. And our customers have become quite discerning. They have very high expectations. And a lot of businesses have actually brought that to be. Amazon, for one, is really made it to where people want convenience, they want selection, they want to get it when they want it, all that kind of stuff. So they've really learned that they can get what they want if they look hard enough for it. And things like Uber, it makes things a lot more convenient for people as well. They're really redefining industries. And I think we need to start to really think about redefining the cannabis industry to be able to be customer focused. You can't expect to go chase a new customer every single time. Like, you replace this customer with another one. You really need to be able to have that customer come in and really have the idea that they're gonna be a customer for life. And the only way to do that is to know what they want, hopefully even before they walk into your business, and then be able to deliver on that, and then keep delivering on that, and grow and adapt using hopefully business analytics and past trends and things like that to be able to give them what they're going to want in the future and adapt to that. Keep your longtime customers happy with maybe some relatively basic needs, but also be able to offer the evolving tastes of the customer. And we're going to see a big change in that in the next 2 or 3 years. That when you move from that kind of the more medical kind of focused model to a very strong recreational model, it'll probably focus back a little bit towards medical over time. There's going to be this pendulum that goes back and forth, and you want to be able to be somewhat nimble, not doing reactive last minute changes, but being able to kind of see the trends and be able to take them into account and really have kind of a customer first, take the customer into account, higher touch type of business rather than just like, okay, let's see what happens and go from there, kind of fire from the hip type of strategy.